Yeah, hi everyone. This is Srinagar Mamidala, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. So today our lecture topic is superposition theorem. So earlierly we discussed various kinds of theorems. So each and every theorem having its own statement. So by applying that statement only, we are going to find the response in the network. Okay. So in similar way, so this superposition theorem also having its own statement. So I am going to state that superposition theorem states that any linear network having two or more sources, the response in any element is equal to the algebraic sum of responses in same element when the sources are acting alone. I am repeating the statement of superposition theorem. Any linear network having more than one sources, the response in any element is equal to the algebraic sum of responses in same element when the sources are acting alone. So here I am taking one example, one network. So in this network we are having two energy sources, V1 and V2, and various elements I connected like randomly R1, R2, R3. Okay. So now I am going to find the response in R3 element by applying superposition technique. Okay. Here I am going to assume the response in R3 element is I3. So the response in R1 element is I1. The response in R2 is I2. How I am going to find the response in R3? That is I3. Can you guess anyone? Which technique is suitable? Yes. Yes. So we can use nodal analysis or mesh analysis. So it depends on the convenient. So which concept is you are having good knowledge or sound knowledge, then you can able to apply the technique and you can find the response. So here, so I am going to use nodal analysis, because earlierly we discussed. So by using nodal analysis we will get one equation less than the mesh analysis. So that is why I am going to apply here nodal analysis to find the response in R3 element. Okay. So before going to that, I identified here two nodes are there. This is node 1 and this is the node 2. The potential of this ground is always 0 node. Okay. So now I am going to assign the current direction in each every element. Okay. Depends on the element, whether it is active or passive. Whether it is active, it delivers. Whether it is passive, it receives. Okay. So my aim is to find the response in R3 element, that is I3. Okay. So I assign the current direction in each and every element, that is I1, I2, I3. So now I am going to apply Kirchhoff current law at node V. So here this is the node V. Okay. So I am going to apply Kirchhoff current law here. So what Kirchhoff current law says? Algebraic sum of currents at any node or junction is equal to 0. So here what are the currents entering, what are the currents leaving, you can identify and you can write the current equation. So now you can see I1 and I2 currents are entering to this node and I3 current leaving from the node. So then what is the equations you will get here? I3 is equal to I1 plus I2. So this is equation 1. Okay. So then you can find in terms of voltage, current in terms of voltage. So I3 is equal to, so V minus 0 by R3. So voltage is the potential difference. The R3 element which is connected between V and 0. This is the V is the higher potential and 0 is the lower potential. Then higher potential minus lower potential. Then what is the equation you will get? 0 V minus 0 divided by R3. In similarly, so I1 is the current passing through the R1 which is connected between V1 and V. Then V1 is the higher value and V is the lower value. Then the current is delivering from V1 to V, so that you will take V1 minus V divided by R1. In similarly, what is the equation you will get here? V2 minus V divided by R2. So you can simplify and you can take LCM and you can simplify. So then you will get the V value. So then you will get the V value here. So after getting this V value, so then you will get I3. So easy to get I3. So what is I3 equation here? I3 is equal to V divided by R3. V divided by R3. So this is the response of a R3 element. Okay. So in similar way, we are going to find the response in same element when the sources are acting alone. So that I am going to take here one source is acting, that is a V1, and V2 is going to short circuit. So same circuit I am going to redraw here. So here I am going to short circuit the voltage source V2. Here V2 is short circuited, same resistance R1, R2 and R3 elements. Okay. Same, identify the number of nodes. So this is node V and this is the 0 volt. Okay. Same, assign the current direction in each and every element. So this is active element, this is delivers, passive element receives, passive element receives. This is also passive element receives. Same current direction I am going to denoting here. Here I am taking I1. So here I will take I1 dash. Here I will take I3 dash. Here I am going to take I2 dash. So what is the equation you will get at this node V? Applying Kirchhoff current law at node V. Same. What is the equation you will get? Entering currents is equal to leaving current. Simple. What are the currents entering? What are the currents leaving? Only one current is entering, two currents are leaving. That is I1 dash is equal to I3 dash plus I2 dash. So this is equation 2. Okay. We have to write current equation in terms of voltage. So then you can according to Ohm's law. Then current I1 dash is the current passing through the resistance R1 which is connected between V1 and V. So the current is delivering from V1 to V. Then V1 is the higher potential, V is the lower potential. Then you will get V1 minus V divided by R1. Similarly, I3 dash, where is I3 dash? I3 dash is the current passing through R3. The R3 connected between V and 0 divided by R3. Similarly, R2 also. Okay, what is the current passing through the R2? That is I2 dash. I2 dash is equal to here V minus 0 by R2. How will get V minus 0? The R2 which is connected between V and 0, then the current is delivering from V to 0. So that is why you will get this. So take LCM and you can simplify, then you will get this V value. After getting this V value, you have to find the response in. What is the same element I have to find here? R3 element. So here also you will take R3 well. So what is the response in R3? I3 dash. Then what is the I3 dash equation here? I3 dash equation. This is I3. So V divided by R3. So this is the response you will get from this. Only one voltage source is acting alone. So here V2 is short circuited. V2 is short circuited. In similarly, next you can short circuit the V1 and apply only V2. So here I am taking positive and negative. So supply voltage V2. So same circuit I am going to redraw here, but here the voltage source is acting alone, means here V1 is short circuited. V1 is short circuited. Only we have only V2 source is there. Next, assign the current direction in each and every element, depends on the active and passive. So this is active, it delivers, it is a passive, it receives, this is R2 and R1 and this is R3. Okay. So what is the R1 element? It is a passive element, it receives the current, it receives the current. So I am going to represent same currents, but the representation is I am going to change here I2. Here I2 dash, here I will I2 double dash here, I2 double dash. Here, what I will take here, can you guess it? both these element. Yes. So here I will take, very good. I3 double dash here, I1 double dash. So this is the node, this is the node V, and this is the 0 volt, this is also node. So next, similarly, you can apply KCL at node V. So this is the node V. So you can identify KCL means sum of currents entering, sum of currents leaving. So what are the currents entering, what are the currents leaving? So only one current is entering, that is I2 double dash. What about remaining? Leaving. I3 double dash plus I1 double dash. So this is equation 3. This is equation 3. Next, write equation in terms of voltage. I2 double dash is the current passing through R2, which is connected between V2 and V. So current is delivering from V2. V2 is the higher potential. Then you will get V2 minus V divided by R2. In similarly, I3 double dash, which is connected between I3 double dash, is the current passing through the R3, which is connected between V and 0 divided by R3. Similarly, you will get V minus 0 by R1. Okay. So take LCM and you can simplify this equation and find the voltage V. So my aim is to find response in R3 element. What is the response in R3 element? I3 double dash. What is the I3 double dash equation? I3 double dash is equal to V by R3. So here you will get V, you can substitute here. Here you will get V, you can substitute here. Here you will get V, you can substitute. Okay? See, finally.